107.5 WGCI, the Shy's number one for hip-hop and R&B. You know what it is, baby. The morning show with the Destin legend Leon Rodgers, the beautiful Kendra G, the shortest damn man in Chicago, myself, Kyle. But maybe not today, though. Somebody shorter than me might be in the studio today.
Till he stand on his wallet.
You know what I mean? Hey, y'all, this is about to be a good day. Two brothers in the studio doing it really big. The biggest comedian in the world right now, Kevin Hart's in the studio. How you feeling?
Man? What's going on? You know, you got a little heel on.
I don't want y'all taking the day.
I'm looking at a prosthetic in the day.
You got on wedges.
I know what I'm looking at. Kyle
got on wedges.
I know what I'm looking at, an inside sole with a little height on it right
now.
We
can talk about it. And possibly the biggest black director ever.
Producer.
Can we say that?
Producer.
Yeah. All things
behind
combined.
The scenes. Appreciate
brother Will
brother.
Packers I'm in the trying. Studio.
Hey,
how you feeling?
As long as I keep making movies with Kevin, I'm going to be all right.
Yeah,
I run out of ideas. I just put Kevin Hart in the movie.
Amen.
You know how they put Drake on every hook?
I ain't mad at you.
That old Young Money move, that's what I do. Kev, what you doing? He'd be like, what you got? I don't have nothing.
Let's make some money.
Figure it out. Let's start right there, though, because y'all have done several movies together. Ride Along.
This is number seven.
Okay.
Yeah. Don't sue him. I ain't going to stop him. See if you know him.
Okay, Ride Along, Think Like a Man 2, About Last Night, Wedding Ringer.
Bam.
Oh my God!
It was weird you went to Think Like a Man too.
Yeah,
okay,
like
there was a one.
Okay, yeah. So that's five. This one is
Ride Along.
Oh yes, yeah, I got right. along. Then so the one from today.
This one. Night School.
Night School. So what is the chemistry that make you guys work so well together?
What you think, Kev?
I'm gonna say it's knowing one another. You know, at this point, I'm very loyal. In Will's business, it's all about chance, where he was in the beginning of my career. And by chance, I mean he was in a position to make movies for an amount of money that made sense, where he could always bring in a return. He wanted to take a gamble on me as the lead in Think Like a Man 1. And they were making that movie for a nice number, and he felt that my career was at a point where it was on the rise and that I could be the guy that could take the lead. Movie ended up doing amazing, crazy numbers. The attention that was then thrown my way was major. He said, Kevin, why not come back and try to do it again?
Yeah.
I said, dude, you didn't fail me the first time. I have no reason not to believe you this one. I believed him again. He came back again with another project. At this point, I said, if it's not broke, why would I try to fix it?
Yep.
There's something about what this man is doing that's right. He continued to just literally give me confidence and also give me understanding of the business, to where I said, we're no longer friends. We're now becoming brothers. And this brotherhood eventually led to a partnership. So right now with Night School, you're looking at producing partners. I learned the production game from him. He baby stepped me into it to a point where my company is now in a place where I can become a partner to not just himself, but to studios. Now we have value. We bring a value to one another. And we understand that we now create opportunities for this next generation of actors and actresses that are coming. And it's about building that brand. And I think the brand that we have together is strong. So you don't turn your back on those that were there for you before. You back them up even more.
Oh, I thought it was because he was black. I thought it was. Yeah, well, I thought it's because he was black.
Well, see, that's where the I guess you could say the quick visual and assessment may be drawn. Two brothers, you may go, yeah, because they black, they riding.
You know what? Listen, I gotta say this, man, because knowing Kev and how he do his thing, 6 years ago, this interview wouldn't have went like that. But now that his net worth is increased, he's saying words like assessment.
He's using different words now.
That's one with assessment.
I'm glad you asked that question. Back in the day, you'd be like, yo, so here's the thing. You crazy.
Now he's like, you talk to financial advisors on a regular. Your vocabulary increases. Hell yeah. No. Kev got that long money.
I don't even know you anymore.
That's the point, though, because one of the things that people talk about, you know, you being the biggest comedian in the world right now, but your business game is crazy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it ain't just you going out there telling funny jokes and being in movies. Like, you set up a business that it's unrivaled, I think, at this moment.
Well, I want the business to catch up to the superstar.
Yeah.
You know, the superstar can only work for a certain amount of time. As a comedian, I love the fact that my following is what it is and I'm able to sell out the venues that I'm selling out. But, you know, you don't know what the timeline on that is.
Yeah.
I can't say that I'm guaranteed to do that for the next 5 to 6 years. But what I am guaranteed to do is set up a business that's going to last longer than me, make sure that the foundation, the last name Hart, has a powerful definition behind it, and that I have value. I have IP. I have content. I have things that can be sold. So this company and the people that are underneath this umbrella are people that believe in my vision and that have invested in me, and in return, I invested back. Sorry to continue to walk down those roads.
Do your thing, yeah, brother. Yeah. I'm just happy to be black.
I'm really in a position to do more. So when you look at Heartbeat Productions, when you look at the Laugh Out Loud Network, when you look at my Laugh Out Loud channel on Sirius XM, you're looking at entities. You're looking at things that are now a circle around the comedian actor Kevin Hart. So how do we continue to make these things powerful with partnerships? You know, Willpower Packer and that production company, the things that he's doing, the more that we do things together, the bigger both of our companies get.
And that's rare, man. I'm going to tell y'all, because I work with a lot of actors in Hollywood. Not everybody thinking the way that Kev is thinking. That is absolutely what separates him, like no bull. The thing about it is that a lot of actors are like, give me my check, tell me where to show up, when is the premiere, give me my lines, I'm good. You know, I'm headed to the beach. This cat is working literally nonstop around the year because he is trying to build a foundation for a legacy for an empire that will sustain when people are no longer laughing at Kevin Hart jokes, are no longer filling out arenas to see Kevin Hart. He's laying the framework for things that most talent, quote unquote, aren't. That's what's making a difference. That's the thing, honestly, I love for him as a black man, because we haven't been doing that long enough.
Yeah.
And there's yet to be a black comedian billionaire, you know?
So is that the goal?
Of course.
How close are you?
100%.
Well, that's I want to know how close you are, Cam. Where we at?
We're trying to pull it.
You see a ship.
That's none of your damn business.
Right back on.
Where we at?
None of your damn business. I don't understand what's going on. You trying to get me knocking in? We've yet to have one, you know, and I think that it's just like these athletes. When you look at the NBA today, you look at these athletes, they're coming out, jumping out the gym different. These guys are shooting further and further away from the basket. And it's because when times change,
they
so
evolve.
Do the people.
Yeah.
You know, you evolve. So right now, to show some evolvement and open up some different doors, create different pathways, all you're doing is setting it up for this next generation of funny to go above and beyond what I'm doing now. You know, when the comedians that set the tone for myself and all the others that are doing it at a great level, you got to think, back then when they did what they did, it was unheard of.
Right.
So the only reason why I'm able to do this now is because of the grounds that were broken. You know, I remember when the Kings of Comedy toured, and it was unheard of that they were doing the numbers that they did.
Right.
Selling out arenas all over at the numbers that they were doing. Film the movie, put it out theatrically. It was, oh my God.
Right.
I can't believe it. And everybody was in awe. But you got to think, that was just an inklet of what could be. So there hasn't been that many people to chase that same vision and want that. So I wanted to go there and try to go above. And that's why I'm doing it at the level I'm doing it. That's where the term comedic rock star comes from. There's going to be people that take it above and beyond that. And you're going to look and you go, damn, comedy has evolved. Where one place people thought that it was complacent and stagnant, it can constantly grow. And that's what I want to do. I just want to give it, I guess you can say, a breath of fresh air and put a nice heartbeat behind comedy. So people
see what you did there.
No pun intended.
It's a value within laughter, man. That's one thing that's never going to go away.
Will, I want to ask you a question. Yo. So working on the set with this man and Tiffany Haddish, like, how do you all get anything done? Because Tiffany is a ball of energy.
Absolutely.
And then Kev brings a certain type
of energy.
Definitely
some clowning.
Too. Yeah, so you know, you got like a Tom Brady and a Randy Moss on the same team. How do you control the energy?
Analogy.
It's like, hey, we got to work, man. Stop making everybody laugh.
You know, at the end of the day, they serious. They're about their work.
Okay.
Here's the thing that makes both Tiff and Kev great at what they do, is that they working like the check might end tomorrow. That's the truth.
Mm-hmm.
That's the thing, you know? And when I approached Kev about Think Like a Man, Hollywood wasn't on some, oh, Kevin Hart is a star, because he had done a bunch of stuff. He had always been like the supporting guy.
Right.
And so that's how they viewed him. He was hot in the streets, but Hollywood is very, very fickle. Tiffany, been in the game for a while. you know, we checking for her now, but she's been in the game doing stand-up, doing supporting stuff. Hollywood is funny. Time, so I'm blessed to have been in a position to put both of them, you know, through Girls Trip, obviously, and Think Like a Man, put them both in a position to where Hollywood could just recognize their value. But when you see the way they grind like, I can't trust Hollywood. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's going to be here tomorrow. Yeah. So absolutely, they was definitely clowning, but when it was time, when Malcolm Lee said action, they were ready to work.
Yeah. Are they ad-libbing? Are you guys ad-libbing or those lines?
Of course.
So, okay, most of it's
ad-libbing. Of course, you can't have the combination of Tiffany and myself in a movie and not allow us to do what we do best. You have to add color to anything that you have. But I can say that the script that was done, we had amazing writers work on the script. Harry, he's in here now. Harry Ratchford, one of the writers. Matt Keller, Joey Wells. We had Glenda Richardson, who worked on it some too. John Hamburg, Nick Stoller. We had a lot of people that had creative input within the funny. So the foundation that we had was great. But when you get that, the cast, it's our job to paint it and add color to it. Tiffany was great. Romney Malco, Rob Riggle.
Yep. Taron Killam. Joe comes in.
It's so much, man.
Fat Joe taking the class from
Jay. I like
Fat
Joe.
He is Skyping in the night.
I saw the movie, so I don't want to give anything away, but I was telling Kevin that I love that you guys bring light to learning disabilities that some people might be living with.
That's real.
That I have myself, and I feel like my coworkers clown me sometimes for being dyslexic.
She says we clown her for being dyslexic.
No,
we
just say that. It's not.
Shut up! That's the only one that I thought it was just dyslexia.
She just blames everything on dyslexia.
She blames everything on dyslexia.
I didn't finish my
sandwich. I can't see that door.
Right.
I'm dyslexic.
Right.
Y'all know that.
Okay.
Right, that's Kendra.
I didn't know the toilet seat was up.
I know we gotta go.
It's all good, Kendra. I got you.
Thank you, Will. I want to say this. Excuse me. I met Kevin.
Migos from Atlanta.
I met Kevin many years ago, right here in Chicago, before he was the big superstar comedian that he is now. He used to drive to the radio station. Very I got true. A picture of us. He would perform at Zany's. I would go to the show. And just to see you become this man that you are, superstar-wise now, I'm so excited for you.
She just showed me a picture. You know, I just want to bring awareness to the fact that I realize I'm aging. I might be on a fast track to Uglyville. I just saw a picture of myself, and it just really made me realize I may be living a hard life. Maybe time to take a break.
Listen, Chicago, make sure you guys go support the movie. Night School comes out September the 28th. Man, we want to thank Will Packer. We want to thank Kevin Hart. You guys hanging out with
appreciate
us today.
Appreciate y'all, family.
Any last words for Chicago?
No, man, look, you said it best. Go see the movie, guys. It's comedy at its best. We don't disappoint. Like you said, this is Packer and myself. This is our seventh movie together. In those seven, we have four number one movies. We have two movies that dropped at number two. We are trying to add a number one. Of course, we can't do it by ourselves. We need you. So go out, support it, and let's laugh.
Bam.
There
Mr.
it is.
Pop, bam. Hey, we love you, Chi-Town.
Nigga, you could have brought some Mountain Dew or something, some Kickstart.
You know what?
We run the Chicago Marathon. Kevin's run the Chicago Marathon this year, too. I've been training now. You're probably going to be back in L.A. when I'm finished. No. It's going to take me about...
As long as you finish. That's all that matters.
I want to run the whole thing, so I did 20 miles is my highest. I'm doing 23. I know I'm training. I'm doing 23 this weekend. I think it's going to take me about 6.5 hours.
You're ahead of me right now. My longest run so far is like 13 miles.
Oh, really?
I'm way behind my trainer.
Oh, so. You better. Well, maybe we could be together then.
Well, no, I'm definitely going to be way ahead of you.
Get the hell out.
It's because she's dyslexic.
I didn't say that to make her feel like we're going to be together.
I ran the opposite way. Yeah, but y'all know I'm dyslexic.
It's dope that you're doing it. It's only the percentage of people in the world that actually run marathons is like 3%, 2 or 3%.
Yeah. Yes.
That's amazing that you're doing it. Get that under your belt.
Okay.
Appreciate y'all being here this morning, man.
Thanks,
that's what it is, WGCI.